Hey everyone, welcome. Last year I bought this soundbar. It's the Sonos Beam, and this one replaced the Yamaha 107. And before the Yamaha 107, I had a, well, normal receiver with big JBL speakers from the XTI lineup, the XTI 100, the XTI 10C, and the XTI 10 or 20 as surround speakers. That was a really nice system, but it was showing its age, so, well, I wanted to get rid of all the cable clutter, etc. So I bought the Yamaha soundbar, did a video about that back then. After that, as I mentioned, I bought this one, the Sonos Beam, and that was a really big improvement in comparison to the Yamaha 107. It had more detail, more bass, especially with music playback. This was a welcome improvement. It just sounded way better than the Yamaha, but of course it was, well, way more expensive than the Yamaha. So yeah, a couple months later I decided to buy two of these, the IKEA Symfonisk speakers. In collaboration with Sonos, they released these speakers. This is one of them. This is the bookshelf version. That's because of the form factor, but you can actually use it as a bookshelf. If you have the mount with it, which I have, you can put stuff on it. Not too heavy, but it can hold some books and stuff. Well, maybe that was the joke, I don't know. As far as I can tell, these are basically the same as the Sonos Play 1, the first gen. Equal sound experience. The clarity is less than with the newer Sonos one. The Play 1, should I say. Well, the first gen. So these speakers are basically the same inside. And I configured this in a surround setup. So this was my center and my left and right channel. And these were the surround left and the surround right channels. And these speakers just costed 99 euros each. So 198 euros and you had the surround setup. And that was way cheaper than what Sonos asked for their speakers. So it was a budget improvement, and I had a surround experience with my soundbar. Nothing to complain. We have wife acceptance factor. Well, yeah, that plays part, then this might be a good alternative to traditional speaker setup. But then 2 months ago, I bought this one. This is the Sonos Sub Gen 3. It's the newest sub in their lineup. Yeah, this is basically where the problems began. We'll get rid of it now. At first, the setup of the sub for our living room, and it is really hot in here, the setup was very tedious. I had to move the sub on different spots in the room and see how the bass would react, because when I was in front of it, I could have nice bass, soft bass, and it was sounding really great. But when I moved over 2 meters, it was or lacking bass, or it was just way too much bass. Then eventually I found out that placing this subwoofer in the back of our room, in the corner, was the perfect spot for our living room. Every time I relocated the subwoofer, I did a true play tuning. So yeah, I was walking like this in the living room, yeah, with blinds closed, of course. It was a very big improvement compared to only what the Beam could output as bass. The clarity of the Beam is also pretty good, so nothing to complain there. And the surrounds, I was really happy with that as well. But now I had great bass, great treble, and nothing in between. The Sonos Arc, the newest soundbar from Sonos, which also just released a couple of months ago. That one, especially here in the Netherlands, out of stock everywhere. I started to do some research on that soundbar and came to the conclusion that, well, maybe a Bose Soundbar 700 would be a better choice. So I bought the soundbar, I set it up, and after that it went dead, and apparently it was updating itself or so. So a little while later I came back into the room and it was done. And I opened the Bose app. To my surprise, I only found 3 music services. It was laughable. Only 3 audio services in 2020. Okay, so I started a radio station, and the sound quality was not what I expected, to say the least. sure, the bass was much better than the Beam. The Bose Soundbar 700 is almost double the price of what the Beam is. After fiddling with it for more than 2 hours, adjusting the bass, the treble, all that kind of stuff, watching a couple of movies, I figured that it wasn't for me. If this is the audio quality that is coming with a Bose Soundbar 700, then I have to look for an alternative. And then I thought, well, maybe the Q90R, it's an Atmos surround setup soundbar. I read some reviews on that as well, especially with music playback, that the audio quality is rather poor. And some complained that the surround speakers were lacking volume in comparison with the front speakers, the soundbar, that is. So, I figured, well, maybe I'm just done with soundbars. So I started looking and see what else I could get for my money, because the setup you see here, so the Beam, the Symfonisk speakers, and the subwoofer, the Gen 3, well, that one would set you back for, let's see, €1,446. I figured that with that amount of money, I could buy myself a decent entry-level home theater setup with normal floor-standing speakers and normal surround monitors and a decent center speaker and even AV receiver, because I will need that as well. So I started looking for that, and let's have a look downstairs and see what I bought for myself.
I went with this setup and these speakers from, yes, Klipsch, and these front speakers are the R from the reference here, so the R620F. Now look at that, dual 6.5-inch spun copper IMG woofers. A ported speaker, so it has a woofer output on the back. It produces a really nice deep and soft bass. And of course their famous horn tweeter adds really much clarity to the audio. So these are the front speakers. And the speaker cable, you can see, is, well, just 2.5 millimeter thick speaker cable. Bought it on Amazon. I will link it in the video description for you.
So
those are the front speakers, two of them, and it has a, well, magnetic front cover, so you can just clip it on like that. Really nice. Really nice looking speaker. So this is the center speaker. This is the R52C, a 1-inch aluminum LTS tweeter, dual 5.25-inch spun copper IMG woofers. This one is not ported. It's a really nice center speaker, nevertheless. I'm quite happy with this. Let's see what I got for the surround speakers. Then the surround speakers, these are the R51M. Also a 1-inch LTS tweeter and a 5.25-inch woofer. These are ported speakers. For the rear right surround, I got a, well, rather large speaker stand. Sure, it gets the job done, but it's quite big. And there you can still see the mount for the Symfonisk speaker. Last but not least, this is the receiver. I went with this one. It's a Denon X1600H. It's a 7.2 AV, 4K AV receiver. It has all the good stuff. Dolby Digital, Dolby Atmos, DTS, DTS:X, you name it, it has it. AirPlay 2, Bluetooth, EOS, Wi-Fi, Ethernet. Really happy with this receiver. Now, as for the home theater part, I had a HDMI switch connected to that, and that one was connected to the projector. That one on the ceiling, for the people who haven't seen it already. That's the projector, it's a BenQ 4K HDR projector. Well, what, full HD? So that projector was connected to an HDMI switch, the HDMI switch to the Apple TV. And yeah, you can see now I have just an old computer standing here, because this one, the Apple TV 4K, apparently doesn't support DTS, which results in that this one just gets a multi-in signal. So this one is upscaling things and resampling it. And that basically leads to that the vocals are not only coming from the center speaker, but from the front speakers as well. So I did a little bit of a test setup here. This is just an old computer. I repurposed it with a clean installation of Windows 10 as a media center machine. It makes an awful lot of noise. so it's not ideal. But for testing, it kind of works. Installed Windows 10, on top of that, a Plex Media Player, the Plex Media Player app, which is really useful because you can still cast media content from your mobile device to your home theater PC. Therefore, the app must be running. Now, with this receiver, I also ran the Odyssey tuning. It's just a simple microphone. You can just install it on a tripod and you can do some sound calibration for your room with your speaker setup. And with this, for me, it resulted in just overall better performance, much more bass. The clarity was already great, but I'm really satisfied with the tuning part of this receiver. Now, let's fire up the home theater PC. Yeah, that's how much noise it makes. Okay, so we have Plex fired up. I will just start transforming. I'm very happy with this new speaker setup. I expected that the R620 app would output a decent amount of bass, but not as much as they do, especially when they are tuned with Odyssey. Now I can add an additional subwoofer to this setup, or two even, for example the 100 or the 120, just a bigger subwoofer. But for now I don't feel the need to. The only thing I want to change right now is the home theater service part, so the PC and the Apple TV. The Apple TV works great. Before the Apple TV I had the Nvidia Shield, after that the new Nvidia Shield TV. But I had a strange problem with that. Sometimes when I powered on the Shield, it would just give me static. And another thing I had problems with the Shield was when I was watching movies with Plex and I would pause the video and I want to resume the video again, Plex or just the whole Nvidia Shield would just freeze and I had to reset it and then we could watch movies again. So after a little while, I got tired of that. I bought myself an Apple TV 4K, and with that, no problems. But the Apple TV has the only drawback that it only supports Dolby Digital format. So I also have an Xbox One S. The idea was to use that for Blu-rays, but it never gets used. No, all the movies we watch are pretty much digital, or we convert them to digital versions. It's just much easier. I can just watch movies with Plex on my phone or on my tablet, and yet that works just fine. So I'm just looking into another home theater PC. And I think that a small form factor PC, like Intel NUC-based system, would be the best solution for that, with a newer generation Intel CPU with at least a UHD 600 plus graphics processor that can do the decoding for us, especially at 4K. Another reason I want to go with the small form factor PC is the power usage of the PC and the noise level it produces. And maybe a passive cooled system. Haven't figured that one out yet. So with that being said, I just wanted to share with you my new home theater setup. Please let me know in the comment section what you use as a home theater setup. If you have any comment suggestions, maybe some advice, you can leave them down in the comment section as well. Thank you all for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.